Well, it took 5 years.
But tonight, an overwhelmingly majority of senators have agreed on a new energy bill.
13 ABC Washington Bureau correspondent Alex Miller says there's still a ways to go, though, before it hits the president's desk.
They say things move slowly in Congress, and Senator Rob Portman knows this all too well.
We've actually come to the floor 3 times now to get this energy bill done.
It's been half a decade for the senator, but he's finally passed his broadly focused energy bill, and by a sweeping margin of 85 to 12.
It was a win-win-win.
The bill targets new homes and commercial buildings to make them more energy efficient by using low-cost equipment. Portman's hoping to reduce the cost of doing business and help the environment.
It's the equivalent of taking, they say, about 20 million cars off the road over a 15-year period.
The road hasn't been easy, but Portman says the silver lining to this long, dragged-out process is that members on both sides of the aisle had time to their 2 cents.
Through the process, more and more members gave us their ideas, and we incorporated those. We didn't ask where the idea came from. We just asked whether it was a good idea.
One of those ideas, incorporating the federal government into these new practices.
The government is the biggest user of energy in the world and one of the most inefficient.
Senator Rand Paul is one of the dozen senators who voted against the bill, saying Americans don't need what he calls another big government program.
It appropriated money that we don't have. So to go further in debt doesn't help America. It actually makes our job harder.
Portman says in the end, this bill will save businesses money, which will allow them to pay their workers more and hire more of them. There's similar legislation sitting in the House waiting for a vote. Reporting in Washington, Alex Miller, 13 ABC Action News.